last 18 years and I've been working in Deccan Chronicle, Outlook, the Hans India, and now with the Indian Express, New Indian Express, Hyderabad. Women and child rights, gender and communities, gender terminology in media are her main interest. As an editor, she is partial to the cause of women and children and has devoted much space for these two of her pet subjects. From profiling a sludge worker in Warangal to domestic abuse victims to interviewing Telangana Governor Ms. Tamilsai Soundararajan, she has covered all of them. Her favorite pastime is to teach the average Indian male how to walk to a woman in a decent and dignified manner over social media channels. A recipient of JFW Women Achiever Award 2014, L'Oreal Social Influencer 2015, Karamveer Chakra Gold Award, APJ Abdul Kalam Award for Media, IndieWood Media Award. She is a social influencer with verified profiles over 80,000 followers across social media. Madam, this is a small brief introduction about you, because we have a lot of things which you have made onto the to the social media through your news channels and newspapers, because of some of the case studies which you have done really have been extremely outstanding. So I think our participants will definitely benefit about your experience regarding being a field worker is totally different from sitting in office in four walls and giving a lecture is a different thing. But you being a hardcore a field worker where you try to bring in the issues of gender right from, as we have mentioned in your introduction, I think that makes a lot of difference, because experiences gives us more information and knowledge which we can share with the participants, like this group where we have around 125 odd participants. So on behalf of Academic Staff College and participant and myself, I will once again welcome you to this session on gender in media, madam, and I hand over the mic to you, madam. Thank you so much, madam.
Thank you so much for the lovely introduction. Am I audible? Am I visible?
Is yes, madam. Yes, madam. Okay. Yes, madam. Okay. Absolutely.
I think we have time till 1 o'clock, right? 1 p.m.
One p.m. Yeah, madam.
Yes, madam. And last 10-15 minutes can be questions, like we did last time.
Yeah, exactly, madam.
And just one more thing, I think this group also I'm addressing is fairly familiar with social media, digital media, right?
Yes. Yes, madam. They are now doing that only, madam.
Okay.
Right. So, thank you, madam. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. So happy to be with you all today, and especially from the comfort of my home. I used to actually last couple of years, I was present physically to talk to the group, but I guess, you know, we'll be happy with using the technology that we have. So I guess I don't have to introduce myself, but let me tell you that social media has played a very, digital media has played a very important role in my personal life. I am a journalist, so it helps me connect with so many people. I mean, 5 years ago, if I wanted to connect to a New York Times journalist, there was no way, you could get his or her telephone number, but today they're able to do, thanks to digital media. So let us drive straight across into the topic of the day, which is gender and digital media. So to just give you an outline, I think the first maybe 20 minutes, I'm going to talk about what is gender and, what is its role in social media, in the digital media, and whether it plays a role at all. Does your gender matter in the digital media? Has it all been equalized, or is there a lot of discrimination? If there is, how to overcome? How can men be a part of this process? How can women be a part of this process? What are the questions to ask? Then of course, I often get messages from many people, and I want to take this opportunity to generally tell everybody here on how to approach professionally, on how to approach a woman on social media, how to get the right answers and not get blocked. That is one of the things. And then, of course, please feel free to keep asking questions so that I can orient my, you know, I can make sure that all these questions are answered. I mean, we are all here. We might as well use this time to make the best of it. So, gender is often, you know, we hear the word gender mostly in on March 8th, which is Women's Day, as though there is no gender on the other days. Or we hear about gender on Mother's Day or Father's Day and specific days like that. But first, let us understand that gender is what you are born with. Yeah, so gender is what you are born with. Sexuality is what you feel inside. Okay, so these are two different topics. Do not confuse the two. People tend to confuse the two. But anyway, that was just an introduction. So, till I guess 5 years ago also, gender would basically mean, So, gender would mean man and women. But in the last 5 years or 7 years, the society has become more inclusive. So I would like to be responsible and say that when we speak about gender, we are talking about men, we're talking about women, we're talking about all the other, which is called non-binary, which means people who fall outside of just the realm of being a man or a woman. So I think you must all have heard of the word LGBTQI. I don't know if you even know the full form of it, but just for your information, lesbian, gay, transgender, queer, there are so many different versions of this. So when we talk about gender, let us be good human beings and let us include everybody into this conversation. But since in India we're still battling with the basics of men, women, rights, who is who should do what and all, I think for now we'll broadly stick to, men and women. So, do you think that the digital media has really equalized the gender divide, the gender discrimination, or has it added to that? Again, you have to take the urban milieu and the rural milieu in this. I think in a city like Hyderabad, if our population is like, let's say 80 lakhs, let's say there are 40 lakh women, I would think that at least 10%, 20% of them are all on the digital media. And when I mean digital media, it means that it's not, people always confuse digital media with social media. Okay, so social media is basically a, you know, sharing network like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, WhatsApp. These are all, email, websites. These all come under digital media. Social media means only a network through which you would be sharing, which, like I said, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and all these things. So digital media would mean anything from websites to email, to YouTube, to all these media, everything coming together is digital media. So in an urban city, in a metro city, women are far more, women are more educated. They have access to technology because obviously, in Hyderabad, you probably have Wi-Fi, better Wi-Fi than in villages. I mean, today, I think there are even places like railway stations, malls and all, which are giving you free Wi-Fi. But if you probably go to a place like Adilabad, you go to Kagaz Nagar, you go to Nizamabad, you go to, one of those smaller towns. I don't know if their kind of network is as good as in Hyderabad and whether women are able to easily connect. Now, of course, because of mobile data, it is so much more easier for anybody to be on digital media. So in a way, I mean, these are multiple things we are discussing, but in a way, the gender divide, basically because of the advent of mobile phones, smartphones, internet, Wi-Fi, or mobile data,
it has sort of merged the divide, because 10 years ago, if a woman wanted to talk about something, maybe her problem, maybe one some issue that she's facing, it was like she had to really go out, perhaps meet up her friends in some place. And most of those times also, perhaps the man in the house had to drop her somewhere and say, where are you going? Ekkada yeltunnavu? Deniki yeltunnavu? Evarito yeltunnavu? You know, there used to be so many questions, even if she had to solve her own problem. Okay, but now with digital media, there is so much more access to so many more resources. For example, if there is a woman who's undergoing abuse, right? A few years ago, you probably had to really go to perhaps ask your neighbor to help, come and help you, ask somebody in the house to help you. Today, because of the smartphone, even if you are not in a position to make a phone call, because typically when a person is in an abusive situation, you cannot really brandish your phone and make a call, and all that, you'll have to be discreet about what you're going to. Sometimes the situations are like that. So a woman is so much more in a position to just send a WhatsApp message to something like She Teams, and keep it discreet, tell them that, and even send the location. I have had handled cases, I've read about cases where women were stuck, they were in an abusive relationship in Hyderabad, I'm talking about, somewhere outskirts of Hyderabad. They could not there was this girl who felt trapped when she went to meet somebody. The boy was trying to harass her, but she wasn't sure it would be a great idea to make a phone call and do what she did. So what she did was she messaged She Teams, she sent the location and tell them that I'm in this very vulnerable situation, can somebody help me? So in a way, digital media has helped more and more women to be able to use the resources which they could not use before. Second thing is, now because of the digital media, availability of digital media, women are able to speak up more and garner more voices of support. If you see, in the last 5 years, there has been a lot of talk about menstruation, reproductive rights, which means not many women even know that they have reproductive rights. They can say yes, they can say no, whether they want to have a child, they don't want to have a child. It is the right of the women to say so. Many people do not even know that something like this exists. But today's day, not only that, 5 years ago, you had to, if there was a conversation of periods, we could not even say the word periods. You had to say or something like that. You had to whisper, you had to use another word for it. You had to say, what all kinds of things, because it felt awkward to talk about it. But today, just recently, I think in the month of November or December, no, I think much earlier, they actually had World Menstruation Day. They actually celebrated this day. Would you think something like this was possible without the digital media? This kind of a, talking about gender issues, would it have been possible? I doubt. So a few months ago, a lot of menstrual health activists came together to actually do a challenge and make women talk about their period stories, how did they get it, what are the issues they face, how do they overcome these painful days. There was so much of talk and so much of knowledge shared, which would not have happened, even 5 years ago, I would say. So today people are talking not only personally, one person to person using phone calls and, WhatsApp or direct messaging on various media. They're also putting it up, and there are YouTube videos where women are talking about this. So this has helped people talk about some issues that they could not talk about a few years ago. Again, thanks to the digital media, conversations are so much easier to do online. Because maybe 10 years ago, if a woman spoke about I am fat, so what? I think I'm healthy and I'm fine with it. why should you do that? People would be like, are you crazy? I mean, nobody's going to support you. But today there is a whole conversation happening on body positivity. You know, the previously it was called body shaming, and now people are in a position to say, no, do not make, do not sort of, do not shame me or do not insult me based on my physical appearance. I am happy with how I am. I could be short, I could be fat, I could be bald, I could be old, I could have, you know, dark circles, whatever it is. I am very happy the way I am. Right, so if 10 years ago somebody said about this, it would be very tough for them to garner voices. They probably had to, you know, book banquet hall, call the media, call the journalists, and talk to them about their concept. It didn't sound very convincing at that point of time. It would be like, no, people wouldn't take that kind of a trouble to talk about what they thought or what is the kind of word that's. But today, because of digital media, they are able to do some gender issues, especially about women, about men, about you know, transgenders. These kind of issues which could not be talked, which could not be discussed, which could not, where we could not find solutions. There's so much that are effortlessly being done on digital media. So I would say, personally, as somebody who writes, who regularly interacts with the common public, I can tell you that the gender divide has certainly reduced because of the advent of digital media. But this is what my perception is, and perhaps people like us who live in the urban cities. But there is shocking, you know. Just let me check some messages. I don't know if these are for me. Sound is not clear.
Oh. Yeah.
Just Madam, a second. I will.
Yeah. Madam, good morning. Madam, good morning. Kindly excuse us to interrupting you. We are missing your most valuable information as the audio is not clear, madam. Please kindly look into the matter.
I'll just connect again. Give me a minute. I will connect again. Yeah, is this better? Can somebody message me?
Yeah, comparatively good, madam. Yeah.
Yeah, I think when there's a phone call that I get, somehow the audio drops. I'm sorry. So do I need to repeat something or better? Okay, we'll take it from here. I would say.
Okay. So. Okay, madam. Now it is.
Okay. Cool. So I was talking about how gender issues. It is easier to talk about gender issues because of digital media. It gives you anonymity. You can talk about an issue without having to be seen, without having to be actually heard, because you can post something and talk about some issue that is close to your heart. You can discuss a problem. Few years ago, discussing a problem was also difficult. You probably had to approach the police. You had to approach a counseling a counselor, but now if you have a problem, so much easier to share it on digital media and make sure that it reaches the kind of the persons you want to. So I was talking about how you know, because of digital media and the advent of technology, women in urban cities are able to connect to the resources. I was talking about how a girl got trapped with a guy she met, and she wasn't sure she could make a phone call at that point of time. She felt very vulnerable, but she could WhatsApp it to the she teams and tell them that, you know, and even send them a location saying that I'm in so and so place, I feel vulnerable, what could I do? And I was also talking about, in fact, today in Instagram, somebody had tagged me for
you know, it's called the Black and White Women Challenge. So, so we all know how in Telugu they say, no, Adadaniki Adade Satruvu, which means one woman is the enemy of the other women. But if there are women in this group, I would say that is not true. I would think that is something that a man has probably told us, because, you know, he knows what kind of strength women can have, and when they join together, it can be very explosive. So never go by that. Women are, a woman is another woman's friend, aid, guide, counselor, friend, whatever it is. So do not go by that. So today in Instagram, everybody, maybe somebody in your friends group also may have done it. It's called the Challenge Accepted. And it's called Black and White Powerful Women Challenge. So this is some kind of a challenge where all women had to put up a black and white photograph of theirs and tag other women who they think are independent, positive, powerful, empowered, and things like that. Okay, it's, people might dismiss it of, em ostadle, oka photo pedte em ostadle, is what we think. But there is a lot of subliminal messaging there. Men may not understand, but it's a great way for women to find more women, to garner more strength, to combine their forces and perhaps discuss about things that they could not discuss previously. It is also a great subliminal way of telling the men outside that all these women are power women, so do not mess with them. It might seem like a simple, silly challenge, but I think the messaging is very, very clear and very, 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 very subtle, yet very clear. But this, unfortunately, is limited to the urban metros, I mean, the urban milieu, the metro cities. If you go back to a smaller place, there are as many restrictions on women like it is offline. So I guess some of you are very young here in this group. I would say you are like in your 20s. And there are also some who are in their 50s and perhaps have, you know, wives or sisters or children, girls, daughters who are in that, you know, teenage. What is the first thing that we tell them? Hey, em avasaram le ippudu photol pettudu em avasaram le social media lo evvarevaro message chestaru endendo aitadi kapal gattal aitadi, right? So whether it is offline or it is online, you know, women are continuing to be made, you know, subjected to the control, saying that no need, why, if you put a photograph, somebody will comment, then he will message you, then he will take your number, then we don't know where it goes to. So unfortunately, whether it is online or whether it is offline, women are always told, don't go out, don't go without telling, don't go alone, don't go without a friend. And online also, don't post nice pictures. Seriously, if a woman has a good picture and she posts, even that seems to be a problem. But luckily, like I said this morning, the kind of challenges we are doing, as women, I personally feel that this is an equal world and I should be able to say whatever I say. Fine, there will be some abusive men, but I have learned how to tackle them. I have learned how to answer, how to respond, how to block them. Everything I'm able to do. So it's all about how we use the digital media to our advantage. Like I said, unfortunately, in the rural areas, there is some interesting data which I want to read out for you. It says that women in numerous countries are 25% less likely than men to know how to leverage ICT for basic purposes, such as simple arithmetic formulas in spreadsheets. UNESCO estimates that men are around 4 times more likely than women to have advanced ICT skills, such as the ability to program computers. So why are women not being allowed to be on the digital media? Because of the patriarchal attitude, because the men have been conditioned to think that an emancipated woman is bad news. A woman who's able to speak out means she's going to be a troublemaker. She's going to land them in some problem. So, why give them a phone at all? Don't give them a phone. And even if you give them a phone, tell them that, you cannot post whatever if you want. If you want, you post a picture of a rose in your garden. But, or say good morning or say good night. But you cannot post more than that. But, so it's a patriarchal cultures often... I'm reading out from a research that was published in the Mint, Live Mint. It talks about patriarchal cultures often prevent women and girls in developing countries from honing digital skills. So even today, women are struggling to use simple things like able to pay, women, I have seen many men, I mean, these women are all proper graduates, maybe postgraduates, maybe some in this own group who are able to teach a class, but ask them to download an app from Google Pay and do a transaction. It will be like, evani naaku telidu meer cheyandi, or probably they are going to, I don't know, somehow I feel that women should stop acting like you don't know technology. It is not rocket science. I think if a man in your life, be your husband, your brother, your colleague or somebody, if he is able to use Google Pay or a Paytm, why should it be so difficult for you? I have seen so many, including my own sister. She would be like, no, you do one thing, send money to your brother-in-law and I'll take it from him. Why do you give power to others? It is, you can do that yourself. You can have your apps. You're intelligent. You know your PIN card. You know your PIN numbers. You know security. There's a two-way security. But still, women do not want to use, the digital media resources. They just want to, say, no, naakaithe telidu ivanni na phone lo adento velli app download cheskovalanta. Why? I mean, you are educated. You live in a city and you would probably use it to buy things as much as the man in your home. Why? I absolutely encourage all women here to please not restrict using digital media to only an email or maybe checking out a few videos, but please use it for 360 degree usage, as in you are the one who probably buying groceries for the family, and in these days it's so much safer to go online and buy from, a Big Basket or a Spencer's or a Ratnadeep than going yourself. So why do you want to ask, others to do it for you when you yourself can probably, probably go and do it? So I also encourage men to please encourage your women in your life to be independent. So if they are like you, educated, intelligent and all, instead of telling them, oh, sorry, name chestanle, name post chestanle, I find that when I'm talking to some women, they'll be like, my husband will send you the pictures. Suppose I'm doing an interview of a woman, she would have probably given me the interview and I will say, okay, madam, can you send me your photographs? She would probably be working as a professor or a lecturer somewhere. But she'll be like, I don't know all this online, akani telidu. I'll ask my son to send you the pictures. I think we should stop. Women should stop playing this, girl in distress and ask others to help them out. So you must definitely equip yourself in all ways to use. This is exactly how we overcome the digital divide. Is that use the resources as much as a man would use. That would be a great start to managing the digital divide. Women may not, this is also something I'm quoting from this research. It talks about women may not have the financial independence needed to purchase digital technology or pay for internet connectivity. Yes, so there are cases where women have a smartphone, But you know, the recharge of that is done by the men, if you know what I mean. There are times when you talk to a cousin or something and say, hey, what happened? You haven't been online for a while. So what they say is, ledu data package aipoyindi. Then you ask, okay, fine, why didn't you recharge it? Then again, they'll say, no, I don't know. My husband does the recharge, or my brother does the recharge for me. Why? You need to do that. When you can use this, you can use that too. Digital access, even when available, may be controlled and monitored by men, or limited to walled gardens containing a limited selection of content. It is known as pink content, focused on women's appearances or their roles as wives, as mothers. So in most places, women are encouraged to only be in groups about maybe gardening, about cooking, maybe health of the family, health of the children, or maximum makeup. You know, there are makeup videos, by the way, are very, very popular in the digital media. But I guess one has to move beyond these very, very superficial things to be able to discuss things that that people could not discuss at a few years ago. It cannot be just relegated to makeup and looks and cooking and all. A woman's life has to go much, much beyond that. Now, coming back to the men, it was so much easier for men. It is so much easier for men to approach a woman in the digital media, because there is a certain amount of, internet provides maybe some amount of cushioning, which helps them to open up. So fortunately or unfortunately, men seem to have an advantage in this also, because they feel that it's so much easier to approach a woman. But please understand that the rules of offline holds good for this thing. It says connection problems can't hear. I will join back. Will connect again in a minute. Yeah, sorry. So every time there's a message on my phone, I don't know what the, you know, I need to fix that up. Every time there's a message or some kind of an activity involving a notification, my voice is going down. Now it's audible. Yeah. So that is the problem, is that whenever some notification comes, the volume drops down and then I can't hear you. I suggest that everybody should use the digital media to their advantage. It's not like only women should use and men should not. So in India, it's very... So how do you actually, approach a woman online? In fact, why do you need to approach at all? Yes, if you are a professional and you want to approach, I suggest that you, instead of having a Facebook page where you don't have anything, you just have a photograph, which is not even your photograph. You have some maybe Pavan Kalyan photo or a Mahesh Babu's photo. And then you send a message to a woman. No, she will not respond, because it's basically you are hiding behind something. So don't do that. I suggest that, everybody should have a profile where you can identify yourself. Be a gentleman and identify yourself. Say to them what you are. Are you a student? Are you a professor? Are you somebody who's looking for a job? Are you a researcher, banker, YouTuber, whatever it is? Identify yourself. Have your photograph and be open and make conversations the way you would do in real life. Right? In real life, would you put on like a mask? not just for your mouth, but your entire face, and then say, hi, can I talk to you? No, right? People will be like, who are you? Why are you in this? Why are you hiding yourself? Right? That doesn't happen in the offline world. Similarly, it's the same with the online world too. Do not expect to hide behind, a fake photograph. Leave no message as such. Am I audible now? Because I again got a message. Can somebody message me saying audible, not audible?
Audible, madam.
We are able to hear you, madam.
You are audible, madam.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. That was good to know all of you are listening. Very nice, thanks. I was talking about just as you do in an offline world, like I said, you're not going to the mask case koni, covering your eyes and all, and then you're not going to go and say, hi, I would like to talk to you, right? Same rules apply in the offline, in the online world too. So first, identify yourself, be proud of yourself, be proud of whoever you are. Whether you are somebody who's working, who's out of a job, who's looking for a break, that doesn't matter. Being authentic matters. So make sure you have a good profile. A profile, you don't have to lie. You can say who you are. You're a student, you're a professor, you're learning, you're in between jobs, in break, gap year, whatever it is. Identify yourself, put your full name, put your this thing. And then you can always say, suppose somebody wants to approach me. In my mailbox, I have so many messages which says, hi, hello, hi, ma'am. I mean, there are like maybe 75 or 85 such messages. I don't know what they're going to say or what they want to say. Instead of that, when I get a message which says, hi, Manju, or hi, ma'am, or whatever they feel like addressing me as, hi, Manju. I am a student of I'm a faculty in OU, and I heard about your session today. But I felt that there was something that I needed to discuss. Can I write back to you, or can I have your number? Now, that is something I would definitely respond to, because you are speaking like a gentleman. You are telling me what you want. You are telling me who you are. You are identifying. So the very fact that, a man is identifying himself makes you feel safe and secure, trustworthy. And then you say, so please do not ever approach a person with just a hi, hello, and end it. It just doesn't make sense. And I'm sure not everybody in the digital media is there only to waste their time. Yeah, there is a vast majority who does that, but I think they do not know what to do. They do not know how to start a conversation. They do not know how to even begin. And please never ever ask things like lunch ayinda, dinner ayinda, had coffee. No, that is the worst conversation starter ever, right? Never do that. I can actually screenshot and show you that my Facebook page, I think currently I have about 22,000 followers besides 5,000 friends. I can assure you that there will be 100 messages which says lunch ayinda, had lunch, what did you have, tea, Sunday special. These are useless things. I mean, if you don't have anything to say, don't talk, right? You don't have to. People are under this impression that whoever you see on social media, you should have a person-to-person, interaction. No, you need not. You might be following, a person who's probably a photographer. You like the photographs, watch it. You don't have to go and make friends with that person. Understand maybe the technique that he or she uses. Find out what kind of lens they use. So use it for something more meaningful. A general waste age of time. So please do not. These are some small etiquette that I want to tell men. Is that, like I said, we all have cell phones, we all have smartphones. All that you need to do is click one picture of your profile and one other picture, and then say which place you belong to. What do you do? What is of interest to you? Is cinema of interest to you? Music, rock music, painting, photography, even chatting. If that makes you feel useful and you feel like you are being friends with somebody, say that. Be open, be authentic, and say that. Number two, do not send messages like, hi, hello, what are you doing? Lunch ainda, dinner ainda. Do not do that. If you are messaging that, please remember that you have nothing to say. But if you have something to say, I suggest you go and say like, hey, you know what? Hi, I'm so and so. I met you at this event, you know, at Ravindra Bharati recently. And I wanted to connect with you regarding this. Be open, be specific, be clear, be elaborate, and be wise. That will open up so many more barriers between men, women, men, whatever, whoever you want to reach out to. Another way of also bridging the digital divide, how do you respond to posts of people? So if a woman has posted a picture where she's talking about some big accomplishment of hers, maybe she has worked very hard and she has got a promotion at office, or maybe she has cracked a very big exam in her life. Despite being married with children and a full-time job, she has done something amazing and she has put up a post. Please do not undermine her post by putting a message like, nice pic, looking good, looking gorgeous. No, that post is not for her, for you to comment on her beauty or her physical appearance. That post is for you to understand what she has done, what is her accomplishment. And if you think it's not a big deal, don't say anything. I mean, that's very, very super annoying when men try to just sexualize everything and just, you know, sort of put everything to their beauty, the way they look and all. No, the post is to tell her, is to tell the world what she or he has, what she has done. So either if you like and if you think it's an achievement, say so, say congratulations. Really good to hear that, or amazing the way you did it. And maybe later on you can also, hey, also nice photograph. But when somebody puts up, you know, a message where she's trying to tell you about the achievements, please do not say nice picture, gorgeous picture, looking good, and don't do that. I hope I'm telling you some very useful tips in, you know, in how to do that. Another important thing is men seem to be under the impression that when a woman logs in late in the night, she's looking for something beyond. Please do not be under the impression. For example, I'm a journalist. Sorry. One sec. So we were talking about, I lost my train of thought there. So the best way of breaking up this gender divide is to be civil to each other and to use this amazing media to grow together instead of, making it tough for people to establish interactions. I mean, anything. This is a free world. Anybody can connect with anybody. You could be old, you could be young, whatever it is, you should be able to do that, which is why I have all my profiles open, whether it's on social, what kind, any message, anything, including except my phone number and my WhatsApp. I am available for everybody across all the media. And the reason I do that is because I'm a journalist. And I would like people to tell me about their stories, their problems, their issues, which I can overcome. So this, and in fact, interestingly, I have also had a lot of women who have gotten in touch with me and talked about problems which say that they could not talk. Like I have people who spoke to me during the lockdown. I'm talking about, one sec. Yeah, so I'm talking about how a woman got in touch with me and told me that she's having some issues at home during the lockdown with her husband at home. And what should she do? She messaged me on Facebook And I connected her to a counselor who could help her how to resolve this issue in a very simple and amicable way. Using social media to not just put pretty pictures or talk to people or tell people you went there, you had a haircut or you just did this. The digital media is so much more than social media. You should all be able to find your own resources online. I mean, there are previously, if there was a person who loved food, people would call that person Tindipotu, right? And dismiss their sort of dismiss them for their love for food. But today, thanks to digital media, there is a whole group which is called the foodies group, which means if you are somebody who's passionate about food and you ate out in restaurants and clicked pictures and gave reviews, you are somebody who's so so very desirable on the digital media. There are websites that actually pay people to talk about their food, right? They're called digital influencers. So these are the people who have used their passion to be able to get beyond, like I said, just post pretty pictures, but use it for something resourceful for their own career or to sort of extend to their passion. So women also, especially when these the digital media is a great space for you to talk about causes that you cannot do in the real world. Imagine if I had to talk about for example, there is a talk about whether we should send a young girl for a school or college picnic. It would be so tough for me to, get some voices, but now I can just put it in, in my WhatsApp group and ask 5 or 7, 6 women in my or men in my group. And so what do you think? Should we send this young girl for a picnic? It's a part of her college project. And the kind of voices gives you so much strength. You're probably discussing about something important. You're talking about how to keep her safe, how she can, use this trip to go and, extend her knowledge. So this medium is something that can be used much more than just stupid pictures or, fake profiles. It is all in the way we learn how to use. And here I will also like to quote some information. In many contexts, women and girls face concerns of physical violence if they own or borrow digital devices, which in some cases leads to their using the devices in secret, making them more vulnerable to online threats and making it difficult to gain digital skills. We are talking about, I'm not talking too much about the rural woman or the women who have to use their phone secretly. I mean, that is such a reality in life. Perhaps you have your maids coming from there, coming to your home and then using the phone or using the internet to connect with somebody. That's because they're not able to do it in their house. In fact, my maid who comes to my house in the morning, she uses WhatsApp to connect with her sister. And, when WhatsApp had come, she told me that she sent some photograph of her children and herself. I think they went to a temple or something. This is before the corona season. She sent these pictures. I think her son clicked her pictures, those pictures. And she sent it to her sister. And then she gave the phone and told me, Amma, Ivani delete chesi. She told me that she sent pictures to her sister who lives, I think, somewhere near Pochampalli. And then she said, delete everything so that if my husband sees my phone, he'll know that I'm in touch with my sister and he'll yell and he will beat or whatever it is. But I'm glad that my maid Basanta is smart enough to anticipate how it is. It's a different thing that she lost her husband about a year ago and all. But I was surprised that she had to lie about this to her husband. Now, why would the husband object to this woman sending pictures to her own sister? Is because the man thinks that today, iroju sister ki pampistadi, rape evariki pampistado nakem telusu. You know how it operates, right? So I was really surprised to hear that. Now, that is the case of many people, you know, in the marginalized societies. But since I think, you know, this particular group does not belong to that kind of a social construct, or most of the people in your life are not, I'm trying to tell you more about, you know, how you can use the digital media to address gender issues. I understand that most of you are also faculties in your own way. So maybe it's a great idea to sort of talk about some gender issues and put it up in your, I'm sure most of you have your own, you know, class WhatsApp groups or your department WhatsApp groups. So I suggest that if you are somebody in a social sciences you know, or a language, you're probably a language faculty. I suggest that don't use a WhatsApp or a Facebook page only to discuss about, you know, class and academics and all that. I think you have this beautiful space with youngsters with whom you can actually create a dialogue. You can discuss far more things than that. So I encourage you to all, I encourage all of you to please create, you know, spaces. It could be a chat room like Facebook or Instagram chat or Twitter chat, where you will discuss important issues related to gender rights. For example, you are a Telugu literature faculty. You could use it to discuss about how gender is treated in Telugu literature. I mean, I have attended a particular panel discussion where, you know, except for maybe a handful of writers in Telugu, where they wrote stories, they wrote fiction with women as the central character, women as a strong, independent character who knows her mind, who knows her dreams, who knows her desires, and how she conducted her life. And then we also discussed about how in Telugu literature, fiction, women were generally sexualized. It was just about she would be there just for the man's entertainment and all. So this kind of a discussion at that particular point was very useful, because I think a few days after the panel session and all, there were two students in that particular university. I forget the name of the university. I think it was Reddy College or something, where we spoke about this. Two students actually said that they would be doing, they would be applying for, you know, a thesis a dissertation on women's representation in, you know, the gender representation, especially women in Telugu literature. So this happened because, in fact, this happened recently only. This was, I think, one Insta live session that I did with them, which turned out to be a very nice way of honing their knowledge and their school and their thoughts for something more than some random discussion on something. And the best way of bridging the gender divide in digital media is to start using the medium in more ways than now. So for that, I think both men and women, and I also find that women also do that. It's not just the men, even women tend to have some fake photographs. Then they get very offended when somebody sends a message. Please understand that they're all learning how to be. Everybody is learning how to be on the digital media, how to interact, connect, make connections online. So do not brush it off, unless, of course, if it's abusive, definitely brush it off. definitely, you know, tell them, admonish them, block them or whatever it takes. But if somebody is trying to genuinely make a connection with you, I think you should. Do not be scared of putting up your photograph. I mean, come on, if we are not able to face online, I don't know what we will do. Just as today, for my work, I travel across, not just in India, but I have traveled abroad for my work. I have represented many. Recently, I was in the US last year. I traveled there for about a month because I was chosen as part of a, you know, an international exchange program for the kind of work that I had done. I traveled across the US alone. I mean, I went alone. I didn't go with my family. Then I recently went to Kazakhstan, which is a Russian country. It's a Russian neighbor. I traveled again on work. I didn't even know the language, but I did. So I feel that online world gives you the first taste of the world. So be brave and be bold. Do not get scared to say who you are. If you see my own profiles, I tell people my name. In fact, I'm not even afraid to tell my age. My birthday was 2 or 3 days ago on July 23rd. So many women are scared to talk about their age. Like, I've seen people making jokes of how old they are. I had no qualms in telling how old I am, how old I turned. I mean, let's break this gender conversation that, you know, if women become old, they should hide their age, or they should not, or they should talk about, oh, I've just crossed my 30s, I've just crossed my 40s, or just crossed my 50s. No, let's keep this world a simple world where everybody is respected as a human being. Why should you not put up your age? Why should you not? Okay, I'm not saying you should put up your map and talk about where you live and all. But as women, I think we should give ourselves a little more view. Tell who you are, what you do, what you like, what you don't like, what is the kind of conversations you would like to do, with whom would you like to connect with, and for what purpose. I think being open and being authentic will really help us bridge this digital gap, and use this to in a way that we all want to desirably use. And for women, there are multiple resources online to know how to be safe online. How to make sure that you don't give off very very important details of yourself, for example, never put up your phone number. Why? This is good. This holds good not just for women but for men too. Simply because once you put up your phone number, it could be, I don't know, maybe misused for you know, something like a banking purpose, or there are multiple things. So whether it's a man or a woman, try not to you know, let your telephone number be open. Do not ever post your live location, again for men and for women, because you don't know who's stalking you, who's trying to use your location to their advantage. So some simple, safe, and you know, commonsensical rules hold good for both men and women. Do we have any questions? You can please, you can talk about your own personal you know, issues, maybe how to open a profile, whatever it is, please message me. I think we have about 15 minutes left. So either you can ask me some questions, please post or speak out. Or I have a few tips kind of a thing to today. How are we doing this? Do you have questions? Or should I go ahead and tell? You can message or you can tell me.
Hello, madam.
Yes.
Nice presentation. Can you please repeat the difference between the digital media and social media?
Yes. Thank you so much for the question. So social media would be basically networks that help you socialize online. That's why they're called social media. So social media would mean Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram. Maybe you could even talk about TikTok, because in TikTok, if you did something, you could share it with thousands of people online. So these are all social media networks actually. WhatsApp also to a certain extent is a social media network, because these days people are opening groups and like you could have, I don't know, 150 people. So that's also, although WhatsApp started off as a person-to-person networking device, as a person-to-person network, today it connects so many people. I mean, there are shopping sites that are happening in WhatsApp. So WhatsApp is also like a default social media. But digital media is far more than that. Digital media would mean a website, a payment gateway, a video sharing network, email that we use. These are all digital medium tools. But I think since most people use social media, I think people who are perhaps in their 30s and 40s tend to use Facebook. But the people who are younger in their 20s, they use Instagram. I think the reason is that Instagram is basically a phone-based network. You cannot post a picture from your computer. So, which is also one reason why if you have children, they will not be on Facebook. They were like, array, all the old people have come to so Facebook and we don't want our pictures, you know, some uncle and aunt telling them, I saw your daughter's picture or your son's picture there. So which is why you will never find your younger generation in Facebook. They have deleted that app and they have moved to Instagram. And in fact, if you have children who are on Instagram, please don't be under the impression that you are able to see all that he or she posts, because there are two kinds of Instagram. One is called Instagram. The second is called Finstagram, which means that is for their friends. So there are, you know, various settings where they post something and it goes only to them and not you as a parent. So trust me, your children are so much more intelligent than us. So, ma'am, to answer your question, social media is basically to LinkedIn is also social media, but digital media would mean every other resource like Gmail and websites and things like that. Yeah. Any other question?
Thank you, ma'am.
Sure, welcome. Do you all have profiles? I don't know. Does everybody in this network have a profile? In fact, you should definitely, whichever medium you are comfortable with. If you are somebody who likes news and current affairs and whatever, cinema, sports, I think Twitter is a great place to be. There are so many conversations.
Good afternoon.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
My name is Dr. Puvin Mazumdar. I want to ask that we were talking about the digital media, the social media, and we can see that there has been a process of naming and shaming in case like movements that we talk about, the Me Too movement regarding gender discrimination and a kind of an answer back, a reaction to those gender discrimination, such movements. So do you think that there is also a negative implications of sabotaging in case of all such movements, like there is a mob mentality in case of social media where without corroborating the facts or without proving the facts, anybody can be victimized? Do you think so?
Yes, sir, absolutely. I would definitely agree with what you said. But on the contrary, I would also like to say that the Me Too movement, which was essentially for women to call out sexual harassment at workplaces, gained ground only because they had a lot of support in social media. In fact, there is this danger that people might name somebody or tag somebody and post about somebody, and people without, checking and all would probably add to it. Yes, this is one of the disadvantage of social media, is that people don't think too much when they are reacting, which is not how it should be. But I would say that the impact or the strength that digital media gave to the Me Too movement is far bigger than perhaps the naming and shaming that has happened to a few men who were not really perpetrators of sexual harassment. I do agree and I do acknowledge the fact that there is a danger, but what is the extent of danger? I mean, today there are hundreds of women who would have never spoken about it, but are speaking there, and because of the strength that they have gained online, they are able to go and file a complaint in the ICC, which is the Internal Complaints Committee. Otherwise, the same woman said that before I spoke on digital media, on social media, I did not know where I stood. Once I started speaking about it, many more stories came that gave me the strength that I am not alone and that I need to fight this. So I do agree that, yes, a certain amount of negativity happens when people unnecessarily blame men who are not there. But the amount of benefit and the number of real cases that have came out are phenomenal. So I guess we will have to go by the numbers and what the impact versus the danger. We just have to go by that. Thank you for that question, sir. In fact, in the last session, I did speak extensively about meeting women, but
Madam, one question here, madam. Yeah, madam, this is Dr. Gopala Sudarshanam. Madam, if any dispute or litigation or issue arises in the future, can we consider the images, documents, and conversation made in the social and digital media as plausible and valuable? Can they stand in the courts as a valuable evidence?
All right. Yes, sir. I think of late the law, the cyber laws and all have been looking into this because these days so many conversations happen in the digital media. So suppose a man and women have had a consensual relationship. They were talking to in a very nice way in social media. But the woman says, no, he harassed me and he trapped me or something. Like you said, yes, the previous conversations, those screenshots, they're all very much permissible under the law because that is also part of who you are. These days, you cannot really say, no, what I say on my messaging is different from what I am. That is not true. So it is very much permissible. If you look up, the new law, which has included, the previous question about Me Too, it gained a lot of ground because women could do screenshots of the conversations that they had with men, which showed that they were sexually harassing. So yes, it is definitely admissible in the court of law, these screenshots, videos, and these things. Of course, depending upon a case to case, which means again, it's quite possible that, for example, so many morphings and all like could happen. There's so much technology that can be misused. So these kind of cases will be dealt with on a case to case basis, what is the kind of case and whether in some cases it matters if digital media proof is there. In some other case, again, there will be privacy issues. For example, a woman has sent a photograph to a man, maybe, and the man has misused it, right? Then he'll say, no, but she sent it to me and I put it up on social media. How can you do? No. It has to, because she sent to him in good faith, she sent to him maybe at one vulnerable moment when she was with him, but it cannot be misused. It cannot be put in the social media, or he cannot name her and shame her and say, oh, but then you sent me this picture then. That in fact would be a crime.
1 second.
Thank you.
Just a second.
I'm back again. So to continue with your question, sir, if the man in the question has misutilized that picture that she has sent him in good faith, he is vulnerable to be, he's liable. It's like considered a crime. So one must be very careful on the kind of conversations that happens in the paper. Like I said, behaving people online the way you would behave offline. That is a simple thumb rule to follow.
Excellent word. Excellent say.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So I guess just 6 more minutes left. So before I go, I would like to connect with as many of you as possible. You're all as I can see a lot of doctorates and PhDs and very, very accomplished people out here. So I don't know whether I have really given you more insight than what you knew. But I know that most academicians are very, very buried into their classrooms, into their work, and they find social media like useless, time waste, time pass, and things like that. But I definitely encourage all of you to please do not ignore this media. Use it to your advantage. So depending upon what kind of a person are you, somebody who likes to connect with your family and friends, you're happy seeing your friends' pictures and all, then use Facebook. If you're somebody who doesn't like all this nonsense of photographs, videos, and shares and forwards, then Twitter is a great place to be. Twitter is very sarcastic, very funny, and small little ones. So be on Twitter if you love news, if you love breaking news, you love to follow experts, you love to follow professionals, you love to know breaking news, then Twitter is the place to be. You are somebody who likes the good things of life, like food, beauty, travel, and things, and be young at heart, then I think Instagram is a place to be. Then what else we have? I think TikTok is good. It's like gone. But if you are somebody who's creative, who wants to put up his own song or something, then try and use YouTube and other such networks. And find your own path. I have many people who often ask me, like, I would like to write for your newspaper and things like that. So for people like that who believe that they can write, I suggest that you use blogging as a very good way. So you can go online and search for blogs. You can just say blogs, B-L-O-G-S, where you can start writing whatever you're passionate about. Suppose you are a psychology professor and you want to write for a newspaper. So typically newspapers will say, can you show me what you have written? They would rarely give you an opportunity to directly write for their editorial pages. So I suggest that you open a blog, which is like a very good, which is a digital mode of writing. Open a blog, put up a few things that you are good at, write some research papers you already published, create a little profile, and then it's a good time to, extend your writing network. But don't use digital media only to just put up some pictures and things. And so connect with me on any of these social networks. My name is Manju Lata Kalanidhi. You can find me on Facebook. I have a professional this page. You can connect with me in LinkedIn. On Twitter, it is @MKalanidhi. I'm also on Instagram. You'll find a verified mark, because I'm a journalist and I'm also a social activist. I have a verified tick. Verified tick means there can be somebody else who tries to be like me. Maybe there is somebody who's also very easy to create a profile like me and put pictures and all. But a verified tick is I'm a creditable, a trustworthy person. So I please request you all to connect with me, not just during this class. In future, you have a story, you have something to talk to me, there is a problem you want, somebody in your family needs. I recently did a story on plasma donation, who you should contact if somebody in your family is COVID affected, and how to get to the right person who can donate blood. So any such resource, please message me on any of these networks. And my email ID is manjukalanidhi@gmail.com. I think Professor Nageshwar would probably share my ID here. So write to me if you have anybody in your family who has created a great app or has won an award. Please write to me. I will be happy to connect with everybody. But in Facebook, I think I have finished my 5,000. So I cannot add anybody as friends. But you can follow me and I will follow you back. As a journalist and social activist, I did my whole social initiative called the Rice Bucket Challenge only on digital media. I did not use any other media. So that's why I'm a big believer in the digital media. And this is exactly the place we should be breaking the gender divide. So I guess that's it for today. Reach out to me anytime.
Madam, good afternoon. Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, my name is Patwardhan GDC Manchurial. So just okay, out of curiosity, I am asking one question. What kind of discrimination you may have to face in the field of journalism, particularly women, compared to men, okay, men journalists? What kind of discriminations you may have to face? Thank you, madam.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for that lovely question. I travel a lot for work. So as a woman, first thing that they ask you is, will you be able to travel? I mean, you are married, you have a child, you have a house. How will you travel? And maybe this particular project should be given to somebody else. Would you be able to go? I mean, will you be able to travel alone? So the discrimination comes in giving you an opportunity because they see you may not be able to do that. But I realize that that there is no point in writing about gender rights and all this if I am not in a position to break this gender gap myself. So I decided to take up any project anywhere in India if it is professionally good. And I travel myself, sir. I have traveled late night flights, early morning, this thing. And I equip myself. I take a 3 spray to keep myself safe. I make sure that my location and all is put when I'm traveling. I inform my family. I make arrangements for my family's safety when I am traveling around. So I just started traveling. I realized how to stay safe, how to do. And that worked well for me. I have traveled to like a bit 6 or 7 countries as a travel writer and all that. And I do a lot of projects. I do a lot of stories which involve maybe going to the city out in the evening. But it has helped me grow in my career as much as a male colleague is. And so people will also talk about, oh, but if she's a woman, she won't be able to go for late night things. She'll complain about this. So I started driving myself because I felt that is safe. I don't have to depend on anybody. So I think for women in this profession, they have to be really as good as the man to be able to do well. If you are vulnerable, you will be discriminated against. So you'll have to be strong. Face, walk the talk, and do what it takes to be there and not lose the opportunity. That is what I did.
Okay, madam. Thank you.
My pleasure, sir. Yeah, so I guess with this session.
Any more questions? Any more questions? Hello, dear participants. Do you have any questions for the resource person? Hello? Okay, right. Can I ask Satyanara Chindam to propose a vote of thanks?
Okay, sir.
Right.
This is my great privilege and honor to propose a vote of thanks to Madam. Madam, really, we are highly thankful to you, Madam, for explaining about the digital media and social media. And you have given live examples, and your lecture is highly thought-provoking, Madam. And they have thrown a light on all the issues, latest issues, which require how to handle the digital media and social media, and how to take care while you making use of digital media, and also for being academicians, it is highly useful so that we can impart this type of education to our students, Madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Highly thankful and grateful to you, Madam.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. Thank you for this opportunity, and I hope you will enlist my knowledge for more such sessions. This is actually the second session I did for OUHRD. Thank you, sir, for this opportunity. All of you, keep in touch anytime, anywhere.